global gold partner which specialized in the HR automated solution. So we proudly announced that Kovaion Consulting is the first company to implement Oracle Fusion HCM in Asia Pacific Japan region. So we are a pure Oracle shop expert in Oracle implementation. Okay. So we have a very rich HCM domain experience from PeopleSoft, HCM Cloud, and Talio implementations. And we have a team of trained and certified consultants. Okay, so we specialize in delivering world-class IT solutions across industry verticals, such as banking and financial services, IT and ITS, staffing, education, and manufacturing. So these are the introduction about Kovaion. So these are some of our customers and some of the HCM lifecycle, our cloud customers, and myself, speaker, I am Lakshmi, and I am a lead consultant in Kovaion Consulting, and I have altogether a 9 years experience in PeopleSoft with various experience in upgrade, implementation, and support projects, and of course in product development as well. So today our webinar topic is introduction to PeopleSoft onboarding feature, which is recently introduced in PeopleSoft. So its setup, its configurations, and its features, and any limitations or benefits it's having, and a demo of how we can onboard a new employee into our organization. Okay. So before going to the onboarding feature, we'll just have a quick introduction about onboarding in an organization. We know, right, when new hires come into an organization, we need to feed in all the necessary information into our HCM system, like our payroll data, benefits data, HR data, everything, right? So all that has to be fed into the HCM system for integrating the particular worker into our organization. Okay, so this is something which is a very big headache which HRs are being facing, because we know that all these things are here and there in PeopleSoft, and there is a no centralized location as such for you know, feeding everything in a one-stop place. Okay, so for that Oracle has come up with the solution. So that is the PeopleSoft onboarding feature. Okay, so this has an integrated solution where we have an centralized location for feeding in all the details, right? Whether your payroll or your benefit information, your dependent information, tax, veteran statuses, all this can be fed in a particular place. Okay, so it's like a very easy transition for workers to, you know, get embedded into the organization. So we know, right, the enjoying facility which we have when we use an activity guide. So that guidance and support is there for this feature also in PeopleSoft. And another thing is a template-based configuration. Like the onboarding formalities may be different from different organizations, different business units, different companies, right? So everything is a completely template-driven. So onboarding for USA may not be same for Canada. So there can be a lot of differences. So those can be completely handled using template-based configuration setup in this particular thing. Okay, so this is just a tile showing how the onboarding tile will dashboard will look in the employee self-service. So it will appear as a tile in your employee self-service. So initially it will be like in a beginning stage, and this is like in a draft condition. So that is a like we can see the steps and all. Okay. So this will appear as a tile. Okay. So to configure this particular thing, these are the steps which we do initially. So first is setting up an activity guide. So all the categories we need to configure, and then we have to, like any other activity guide, we already know that we are using it for benefits and all that. So for that, we just create a template, and then we'll configure the documents. Like we see, right, a lot of policy handout documents, everything has to be fed in to people who, like company will have new policies, handbooks, and also those have to be presented to employees when they join. So those configure a document option, and then we have to do a template assignment. This is a completely new feature in onboarding where, you know, it's not a static template which we configure, but people itself can do a dynamic assignment of template based on your rules or your organization rules based on your company, department, etc. Okay, so that is a template assignment feature which you can set up. Another is like the in general installation settings you have to do for onboarding, and then manage onboarding, like where you assign an employee to a particular template, or if you want to do any maintenance over there, you can do something in managing. So these are the major configurations involved in this particular feature. Okay, so this is a activity guide composer. So setup SCM, common definitions, activity guide composer, category, category. So here this is the setup which creates the categories for an activity guide template. So my category is onboarding. So here there are four tabs. Okay, so maybe like at the end we can have a demo of all these. So just as of now, this is a place where we just configure a category of onboarding. So for this effective date, we just give all these things. We'll just see. So this is the category composition, and next is the template for activity guide. So we already have, right, this setup SCM, common definition, activity guide composition, templates, activity guide templates. This is where all the templates, like whether it's for benefits or open enrollment, everything, life events, everything is being configured. Similarly, we have delivered templates for onboarding as well. If you want, you can add your own template, like for your, you have belong to a different country, you have a different onboarding rule, you can add a new template here. Okay, so there are some standard sets of processes which are configurable in this particular template, which can be selected. Okay, while we do the template design, and then next step is creating the document. So that is also in under setup SCM, common definitions, configure documents, documents. So here we can configure the documents, which like it's like a file attachment feature where employee can see the documents which are being uploaded in it, and then like we go by a template, right? First we have created a template, and then we will be attaching a document group for this particular template. Okay. So in that document group, you can upload whatever documents to be available in that particular template once you onboard. Okay. Now this is an employee documents page. Setup SCM, common definition, employee documents page. So this is where we can see like which all documents the employee has viewed, and he has acknowledged, and we have downloaded it, or what he has done with the document. That can, these details HR can monitor over this particular place. Okay, now next is the template assignment feature which I mentioned earlier. So this is the part where you do this template assignment, set of SCM, common definition, activity guide composer, activity guide utilities, template assignment. So there is a general tab and then a template assignment tab. So here we just mention some keys, right? So this regulatory region, this company. So based on the data which we feed in here, based on those keys, whether it's a Canada regulatory region, then if the employee belongs to this reg region, then go for this assignment of this particular template, or else if you are in USA, just go for this template. So this type of rule, we can set it here, okay? So that you don't have to, go. This is something which you can mention in the installation settings, whether to go for a template assignment or whether you go for a, a constant template which you configure in your installation. So this choice can be made between both. And if you use this template assignment feature, based on the employee data, the assignment happens. Okay. Now this is the installation page. So this is for assigning onboarding information for a worker, and it will also contain roles, notification templates also, and attachment storage, all these. And here are just I mentioned as such, we can just whether we can select a default template or a assignment feature we can select, and so we can just select which all notification template, like normal PeopleSoft notification templates which you select for sending out emails, we can select those templates, what to send when notification goes, and all these can be configured here, and which all role they should be available. Now this is a managing page. So here we assign the template to a particular employee. And if you want to delete or manipulate something, we can do it over here. So this happens for triggering a person who has missing an assignment trigger. And if you want to correct an incorrect assignment of a template, you can do it over here. Okay. Now, next is the self-service thing. So this appears in the self-service. So this is just a slide demo. So before you start, you just see a video of how we can how we can use this particular functionality, and then you can have, this is a onboarding template for USA, so you can see where to start, and then welcome page, then I-9, you can file here, disability, veteran status, ethnic groups, documents, attachments, and everything can be seen here. And then personal details, there is a particular place where you can feed in all your personal details like emergency contact, marital status, address, and all that. And contact details, name, photo, everything can be added. Basically, your personal details. And and then your talent profile can be added, like degrees, competencies, licenses, and all. And then benefits, your like if it's an open enrollment started, you can enroll from here also. Dependent details, API consent, all these details can be added from here. And finally, the payroll details like your tax, direct deposit, account number, and all the deductions, and W-2. So everything can be added from here. And finally, you can see a summary like which all have been visited, what is the due date for everything, what are we find completed, and which is yet to complete everything, you can see. And finally, we can submit it. So on completion, this onboarding activity will get completed, and furthermore, it will go into this particular stage. Okay, so this is a activity is completed, and if you need to do anything, you need to contact the administrator. So we'll just see a demo of it. In your employee self-service, you can see the onboarding tile. So here you can see the activities. So this is the first thing. So here you can play a video like how to navigate through the activity guide. So here is a welcome page. Hello. So next is the I-9.
Hello. Just hold.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
Yeah. Kovaion consultant. Hello.
Oh yes. Hello. Okay. So next is the I-9. Here we just give the I-9 details. So once you submit your I-9 details, then you can see the disability. So here you can give the disability, like whether you are disabled or not. Then finally, the veteran status, whether you are a veteran or not. Then ethnic group, whether you are white, black, or those things you can add here, like. Okay. So here a document section. So just like that, this is a handbook. From here you can download it. So this may be the policy of the organization. Then attachments. So your marriage certificate, birth certification, residence proof, everything can be attached here. Then personal details, emergency contact. Marital status, where you are married or not married, all these details. Then additional information. Okay, then verifying addresses, contact details, name, photo. So just we can enter everything from a particular place. Then verification of name. Then finally, you can upload your photo also here. Then talent profile. There you can give your degrees, competencies, licenses, and certificates. Like competencies, whatever you have completed, degrees you have taken, then licenses. And then benefits. So it's like very user friendly. Like it's like simply like how you type in the information and just say it. So it's like.
Hello, Lakshmi.
Hello.
Lakshmi, Samir here. Lakshmi.
Hello.
Lakshmi, Samir.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, Lakshmi, we are hearing lots of background noise. So could you please ask somebody to stop that?
Hello.
Yeah. Please go ahead. Yeah.
Okay, so and benefits info. So here we just enter the dependent information and all your benefits, enrollment, everything we just enter into it here. Okay, so whenever the open enrollment opens here, from here you can enroll in your benefits also. So all the dependent details can be entered here. And then this is an ACA consent. So this is a form 1095, which a consent form which you can submit it. And then next is a payroll information. So this direct deposit details regarding your account. So what is the bank account you are using, and your tax details, and your deduction. And W-2 consent. So all this can be entered here. So it's like a very user-friendly thing. Like this. First of all, before you start, you can play this video and see how the activity guide can be easily configured. I mean, all how can you can see this? Just I'll pause this video. So once you watch this itself, you will just have a complete idea like how easily you can do all the complete end-to-end configuration over here, right? How you can do the entire data you can insert from this onboarding thing. So this is also welcome video from your organization, like welcome you. So all these other things I have mentioned. Already, like how you can.
Hello and welcome to our you join us as our newest member, and we anticipate your continued excellent contributions. We could not accomplish what we do every day without our employees. We've got a great place to work with a great future, and we're delighted that you are a part of our team. We're confident that you'll find working here a rewarding opportunity.
So all these details you can mention here. So it's like a completely like end to end all your new hire data. You can just enter in a particular source on top. Okay, so that is the main advantage of this onboarding. So currently we know that we have to move here and there for inserting all this data. So now it's like a complete data can be entered from a particular location only. Okay. So now moving to the setup. So just I mentioned earlier. Now, this is an activity based category. So this is the onboarding category which we show. So here we just mentioned all the things which is related to this particular category onboarding. So this is the package and this is the class. So this class can this class is particularly fired when you just take this particular activity gate. So these are the records behind it, context records, and this is the actions like complete action, marked like begin. So all these actions which is pertaining to that activity gate. And then whatever images you need to upload during your activity gate can be configured here, and all the steps also can be configured here. Now template. So this is another our benefits like events and open enrollment. So similarly, we have created an onboarding template also for India, USA, global. So we just edit it here and we update it here. So here we can just see the update template. So it's a delivered template. We cannot delete or modify it. So we just can see it. If you want any change, you have to create your own template. This is the template. Now moving to next thing. So we just saw the documents. So these are the handbook and all that, whatever if you want, you can view it and download it. So this is the place where we upload the documents and we attach the documents to this particular template. Then employee documents. Now here we can see okay, which all employees have downloaded what documents. Okay, this person has downloaded this document or he has uploaded it. Then installation. So this is the installation page which we saw, the roles for this particular onboarding, and then initial work template, and what is the notification template to use, and then which activity we have to use, and what is the template assigned. And here, as I told, we can go for a template assignment or we can go for a default template. Whether to use a assignment template, then that will be like based on the rules, it will be assigned, or if you use the default template option, whatever template you are selecting here will be assigned. So finally, managing. So here we just assign the template to that particular employee. So this is the particular end-to-end setup which is required for an onboarding event, and through this you can create the activity guide and do the template definitions, and finally you can onboard the particular new hire into the organization. Features wise, these are the features of this particular thing, and this will enable the administrators to set up the template using activity guide composer, and then we can identify the steps, and then we have a template assignment engine for defining your rules for the organization, and you can automatically assign, and then it gives the administrators an flexibility, right? Okay, so very easily we can manage the templates and maintain the documentation. So we can provide a link for the dashboard, and where we can see them. So some benefits and limitations. So all new hire data can be entered from a centralized location, and organizations can select the template based on rules, and the guided process will improve the user friendly. And only one limitation is that the delivered templates are not modifiable. If you want any change, you just save as and you have to add a different step. So any questions?
So yeah, Lakshmi, thank you very much for giving us such nice information, and it's really helpful for HR people, those who want to implement this onboarding functionality. So if anybody is having any questions, please drop a question in message or messages. So till time, Lakshmi, we received some queries from our colleagues. So first query is from Suresh. That how can we modify the deliver template?
Yeah, just I told, right, the only drawback which is as of now having is that the deliver template is not modifiable. Okay, just we saw, right, the only thing is like it's little bit difficult to do the initial activity guide and all the configuration setup. Okay, but once you do it from a functional perspective, so then once you do all the setups, then it's very easy for any new hire to use it. Just we saw, right, how user friendly it is, like the step by step process, how easily. So the major advantage is that the utilization of templates, so that you know, based on the organization, we don't have a static, you know, room, like if my organization do not have an INN, you can remove it. If you want, you can remove it. So it's by delivered USA, Canada and all, we have some templates delivered. Fortunately, like, we cannot edit this for it. When we try to edit the activity guide template, it was showing that the delivered template is not editable. Only thing which we can do is we can save it as, and then create something like that, and then then we can remove the steps we don't want, and then we can use it. So that is the only workaround which I am finding. So as of now, that is the one solution.
Okay, Lakshmi. Yeah, thanks. And so our second question. Yeah, Lakshmi.
This is the page where we see set up the template. So we have a set of like we have in life events and other things, open enrollment, right? We have like only the specific set of activity guide steps which is being defined here also. So those like if you want, we can add more steps into the activity guide and we can include them, we can edit them. So only thing is the delivered name we cannot have. We can save it as and then we can just include it. These are the steps which is there in this particular thing. If you want, we can update it. Okay, you just save us and then do it.
Okay, yeah, Lakshmi. And second query is from Shiva actually. Can we re-edit the forms once submitted?
Can you say that again, Samir?
Yeah, the question is, can we re-edit, means can we change the forms once we submitted?
Okay, changing the form once we submit, so I just do a transaction. Once we submit it, it is not editable actually. I just saw it in the slide, right? Your activity guide has already been processed and now it's not editable. So it will just show like once you then it's not an editable. So that is a problem here. So I'll just show you that how to just and just give some basic information and try to submit it. This page. Now this is being submitted. We'll move to the next section.
disability, like I don't have any disability, it's just something special. Okay. Let me move to the next thing. Veteran status are not a good excuse and whatever which is not something. So this section is being submitted. Here, you can add a netting group. Just adding something. Now here, as I told, I can download a handbook, I can register now. If you want, I can mark complete also. And then, attachment. Here I can upload some marriage certificate and all that. So it's very user-friendly. Like we have some effort in setting up and making the configurations. Other than that, it should be very easy. And if you are using a delivered template, then it's very easy.
Yeah. Okay, Lakshmi.
Okay.
Yeah, Lakshmi. Could you please help us to let us know where we can see that downloaded document with the navigation? Yeah.
Okay. Downloaded document will appear in your download. Here, I just downloaded now. From your browser, download it. Yes, downloaded. It will download in your local drive.
No, but in PI, you showed drive.
Okay. You want to
Yeah. So that navigation, could you please help us to know that?
This is the document section you can see. Here you can download that handbook.
But if I want to see for individual employee then?
Individual employee, if an administrator wants to see for individual employee, then employees, then one page I saw, right, set as STM common definition, onboarding, then there is a component called employee documents. There he can see whatever he has downloaded and if some marriage certificate, something he has uploaded, all that documents maintenance can be done there.
Okay. Yeah, Lakshmi. Yeah. So this is from us actually. If anybody is having any query, please drop any query or questions in message box.
Yeah. So just do one transaction so that you can also see. So this emergency contact I saved. So it's like end-to-end hire we are doing. Okay. So all the details, like we know right how difficult it was to do it in another way. Right, you have to do a lot of navigation and all that. So it's like a one place where everything can be entered, and just during the hire, some personal details must have been entered, some HR. So those fields here, we just verify whether it's correct. If it's not, that there is any discrepancy, you can just add your say your HR that this is not correct, and you can get corrected. Also, here you can add your photos, and not uploading photo. You just can upload. It's not mandatory. So here you can just add your talent degree, right? It's not a mandatory, so I'm not adding it. I'm just skipping. So then finally, benefits. If you want, you can enroll your dependents. So it's like very easy, like any new employee coming in your organization will be completely confused what to do, where to go, what to enter and all that. So if it's a one-stop process where you have everything, it's very easy. So here, from here you can enroll your benefits also. Now this is a payroll, where most important detail, you can add your account details. Your routing number, account number, bank details, check or amount, anything can be entered. Routing number is not. This is the format. Okay, let me just check. So, any tax? Tax related, so not eligible actually. Then any deductions for voluntary deductions. So these deductions can be added here. Something like the cafeteria charges. The person is not eligible for that. So now we have like once we visit everything, just like the feature of activity grid, each and everything will go green. Okay, so now we have the summary. Now here we can see everything on the single page, right? What are visited, what are complete and all that. So once we have done with everything, we just click on complete. So now this has become complete. Now child has gone completed. Now if I click on this, so it's like it's already been completed and we need to contact the admin. So any more doubts like in setup and all that? Any more questions? Any questions?
Please drop your questions in message box so can Lakshmi can answer.
Now, if you have any queries, please post it on this chat. I will see to it. This is a very good feature which Oracle has implemented. So only thing is like if your organization has lot of new rules, like you have to go for a fresh template, and then once you do it, it's very easy for the new hires. Composer. Actually, like normally, whatever you do in your open enrollment and all, right? The steps you add it in your activity guide. The same method only you can just follow. Nothing different. Like we have a delivered set of actions which is available in the guide. So only those you can do. If you want, you can configure new and add it in the activity guide setup, and that you can include in your template. Is there any possibility to revert complete on board?
Okay.
That we can actually go to the manage component which we already saw, right? There. Like okay, you have already inserted all the data and you have saved everything. So this is something like once whatever you are saving it here, it goes to the PeopleSoft tables. Okay, so once the onboarding is completed, you just see a message also, right? Furthermore additions are not possible. You have to contact your administrator. That is the only thing. Okay, so complete onboard, you cannot move the data. So if you want to remove this particular onboard from this particular thing, from seeing from a person, if that is what you have meant, then that is possible. Like if you go to the manage template and there you can do the maintenance. But other than that, whatever, if you have completed all the thing and you have saved everything in your database, then revoking is, I don't think it's possible. If it's the way you have meant. Another question we have is any restriction of video size? Okay, the previous question was any possibility to revoke the onboard. Then another question is any restriction of video size and type. Okay, now video again, there is a setup which we saw, the first one. Where you give the video specific, see this this particular category setup, if you go there you can have some setup regarding the videos you have uploaded and all that. So there if you have some provision there only, like you can do. So these are some additional setups which you mentioned. So actually, this is a place where it's mentioned in PeopleSoft where you can resize the video and all that. Unfortunately, I'm not finding that particular place. But if you go to PeopleBooks, it is definitely there. Like this is a place where you resize your video. But I'm not finding it here in my instance. But I remember reading in PeopleBooks that here you can resize and do some video settings. I'll just explore that and let you know about it. No, as of now, like the URL link, like in the PeopleBooks, like it was the URL link which was given, like YouTube. I think you can give your local videos also there. I mean, it's not that, that it should be from YouTube only. Like you can give path from your media player or whatever you want. That also you can give. So that was another question, like whether the media player works or we need to YouTube only. Any more questions? What is the significance of match instance in display and processing? This question, I will just get back to you, Kishore. What is the maximum instance for display processing? Okay. Any more questions? In display processing, we had there was a video setting section itself in this particular tab. So there, most of the setups regarding your video and display can be done here. So any other questions? So altogether, I'm telling the only investment is it's like creating the template from scratch and publishing it. So other than that, from a user perspective, it is very easy to feed in the data and submit it. So once everything from a centralized location, you can feed in. So in that way, this is an amazing feature which PeopleSoft has recently introduced. So we know that from a HR perspective, how much difficulty it is to hire a person into an organization, and when a new person comes into organization, he will be difficulty in understanding where to go and what data to update and all. So in that particular perspective, once you have this particular solution, it's like one place where he can go and feed in from his end-to-end details and just come out. So based on the rules and all, you can configure all the activity based whatever customizations and enhancements, whatever you have, we have done for benefits enrollment things. Similarly, all those things you can apply it in this particular feature also. More or less open enrollment thing, which people are very familiar in PeopleSoft. The onboarding feature is also something very familiar. So we can there is a scope for adding lot of customizations and all. So whatever new, if your organization policy has changed, your handbooks have changed, you just go to this document place and just upload the new handbook. So it's very easy. So everything is setup driven and configurable, so which makes very easily the new hire to onboard. So any other questions? How to enable used activity guide categories? So it's another question. So this is the place where we just go for categories. So here we have the onboarding category. So if employee uploads attachment, where it will be? So in that setup, you just have a URL as well as a file attachment record, right? Where the attachment goes into your PeopleSoft system. So the same record only it's getting stored. Okay. We saw a setup. How it will? So he is asking how it will distinguish for each employee. Yes, it will distinguish for each employee. There is a key field associated with it. With an employee ID key only, it is being associated. So if you just go to the favorite employee document. So See here, we have just just we saw right. To, I mean, this was already like I have done a transaction and that was the one which I have inserted. And second one is the this transaction which we just now done, right? So it's like based on the key field, it is being going to different employees. So based on the employee ID key, it will be distinguished, not an issue. So any more questions? Okay. Any more questions? Like, I mean, I'm very happy to address all your queries. Like, I mean, there should be like some good takeaway from this session, because once you, like I have mentioned all the end-to-end configurations to do to make your onboarding up, and I think the basic working version of onboarding should be up once you have done all these configurations. So, I mean, if you need more customizations, okay, we have to put some additional efforts. Other than that, a simple onboarding for an existing template, once you follow all these 6 steps, it will be up. So then you can bring in new employees in your organization. Okay. So this is where you have to select. Hello, any more questions? So this is your, so if you can invoke the email notifications as well. Okay, so here we can just configure the whatever notification template and all should go for mail. So in that case, we also like, if you just remainder also, we have saw the right thing settings, like if any remainder is missed also, mails will send out and we can finish it on time. So any more questions? Okay. So I think I mean it's a little bit picked up feature only, but maybe if you invest about an hour or two following this particular step, then you can make your onboarding up, and then you can start bringing in new employees in your organization. And one other important thing I just forgot to mention. So whatever employee you are choosing, he should be a new hire. Okay. So if you are trying to bring the onboarding time for a terminated employee or a already existing employee, I don't think that he may be able to work. So if he should be a new hire, and then or a rehire also is fine. Then you do all these configurations, and then you can bring the onboarding time to your employee salary, and then you can start. Hiring, I mean, filling in all the hire required details in your organization. Okay. So that's the one thing which you have to mention that in mind. And so I hope this session must be like little bit informative. Thanks for the joining everyone. And if you have any queries and all, you can mail us in our particular email ID, peoplesoft@kovaion.com, and we will be very much happy to answer all the queries. And I think the player size related query which one person has asked, I will just explore that and where to do that settings, and I will just get back with that answer. Okay. Thanks everyone for joining.